My name is Phil Gaimon. I was a pro cyclist for 10 years, but at the end of 2016, I realized that I had to quit racing and get a job. I couldn't be the best at pro cycling, so I've decided to be the absolute worst at retiring.
Boom, we're gone.
We're here on Cookie Corner on Mount Hamilton. I think the KOM is going to be smashed today. This is a World Tour race, and I'm going to come back and smash it tomorrow morning for my YouTube series. Worst retirement ever. I'm probably not going to get it, but I'm going to try. I'm going to try tomorrow morning.
Cool. Perfect.
There we go. Yeah.
We only have one person watching this.
I mean, we'll keep going.
Hey, you! Don't stop watching.
Keep watching. This is going to get cool.
Yeah, Phil, do something cool.
I'm already wearing. How could I get any cooler? I'm peak coolness. We're at Cookie Corner.
Yeah. So we're just show me your butt.
Oh, look at that.
One way to get cooler.
Oh, now there's two.
That's what happens when you put my butt on screen. So the main thing is we're promoting my Fondo this week. We're following Tour of California around. We got little booths and we got cookie corners on all the critical climbs. So we give cookies to fans and we heckle the riders and we're just generally obnoxious and try to get on TV. On the way up, I was heading up to Sacramento. It was a road trip and there's a lot of flies around. I hope the camera gets all the flies that are eating me today. And on the way, like There's a climb that people haven't really heard of outside of like San Francisco, but because it's close to San Francisco and it's like, I don't know, it's like a very legendary climb in the cycling community, in the Strava world. It's called Old La Honda. And so on my way up, I kind of took a detour. I'd never done it. I wanted to see what it was like. So I didn't think I was going to have a great day, and it wasn't really worth, like, because it's sort of a niche climb, it wasn't going to be like an episode of the show, but I figured, like, I'm going to make it like a little mini thing, and I put the GoPro on, I was going to overlay the power. Of course, only if I got the segment was I going to do, otherwise you'd have no idea I was ever there. So I had my little handy cam, I had my GoPro, and I recorded this whole story, and I smashed the climb. That was good news. I had a really good day, and I smashed the climb, and then I went to meet a buddy for dinner in Oakland, which is where the story turned sour, which is I came back and my car was smashed into, and my cameras were gone, and my clothes and my laptop, all my things were stolen, except my bike was okay, so I was barely mad. But it sort of soured things, and that mini episode doesn't exist. You gotta take my word for it. I went fast up Old La Honda, and now we're here, and it's been a long few years. I had to like drive back and forth to get my car. It was a mess. And now we're doing a lot of Fondo work. I'm on my feet, but we're gonna do Mount Hamilton. We're gonna see the race is gonna blast by here. Hopefully not too. Some of the guys will be slow enough to stop for cookies, but the guys at the front are being all game faced. They're gonna be really annoying. But we're gonna do the cookie corner here, and then tomorrow morning, super early, because we gotta get to Pismo Beach or San Luis Obispo or something. I'm gonna go for this climb. I'm gonna try and go faster than the bike race up the climb.
Fortunately, I happen to know a guy who knows a little something about Mount Hamilton, and he agreed to give me some advice today. Thomas, what the hell do you know about that stage? Why or about that climb? Like why are you worth giving me advice on this? What do you know?
I know that if it's in a race, in a 2015 race, then it's a pretty critical moment in the race, and you should go flat out to the top.
Yeah. So okay, you won something there. Is that right? There was a bike event that went up that mountain, and like it went well for you.
Yeah, yeah. I was with some other losers in the break and.
So there's this thing I'm trying to understand. There's this thing called bike racing where it's not on Strava. There's a thing called like people, yeah. There's these dudes that you guys race in a pack.
It's kind of weird.
And so like you race
there's
in a pack
going on as well. You know that thing when you sit behind someone else?
I'm sorry.
Oh, this is the other element of the story is we have pro cyclist Abby Mickey, who is a Phil's Fondo guest.
Come and get it.
Abby is one of our featured Phil's Fondo pros and friend of me. So Tom's the guy who gave us advice on how to pace this climb. It's her boyfriend. And so she's like, she's freaking out. She's hiding it well, but she's been freaking out. She's on good behavior on camera. But he's won this stage before, and he might win it again. And we're going to freak out when he comes by. And he's going to just ride by and not take any cookies because he's in serious face. And he doesn't do gluten. That would be bad if he had the cookies and then he has like a seizure or something. Whatever happens, you have gluten.
His stomach gets all.
So he has diarrhea. That's what happens. Is Tom's races by and he has a cookie to be polite and then he doesn't win because he's like just sick. Yeah, that's what'll happen. Just me and my good buddy Wiser. That's all I ever need because I drink alone. The song.
Certainly,
we're almost here. We
he
gotta get
is
ready.
Now a rider with a big reputation on his back, but I think he's probably the strongest rider in this breakaway group. And the professional teams, the World Pro Tour teams.
Yeah, it's got to be the right song.
Yeah, what do we think? I know I couldn't see the love the night of fire. No one was the same. Instead of making love, we both made a
ceremony. And now I coincidence, and we're in his neighborhood. Have some cookies, Freddy.
This time I get cookies. Oh, thank you.
We want Freddy in every episode now. He's my favorite.
All right. Well, thank you, Phil.
Everybody.
Yeah, great to see you again.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
So I'll see you at Washington and Pike's Peak next, right?
You yeah.
Okay.
That's good. All right, man. Thank you.
Last night I finished the stage yesterday. We were running around chasing people with cookies, and then I was kind of like tired when I got back to the hotel, but I was like, I better spin my legs. I'm trying to go up Mount Hamilton really fast tomorrow, and I've been running, which isn't good for the bike legs. And then I got a text message. I was like kitted up, ready to go. And then I heard that Tom's crash. I didn't know anything about it, but I heard that he crashed. And then I had no idea. And it's not like when you're a pro, you crash. It's no big deal. But then I got a text message from Abby that he was in the hospital. And my first instinct was like, well, I got Mount Hamilton tomorrow. I got a ride. And then I was like, no, wait a second, I'm not a pro anymore. I should go to the hospital where my friend is. It's so like back in the day, that's, you know, like, it matters. And now it's like, no, I'm a pro now, or I'm not a pro anymore. So I go to the hospital where my friends are there. I don't miss that. I'm there for people. Which meant I didn't get to ride yesterday. And so that's the bad news. The good news is that when I was at Cookie Corner, a lot of locals came up and they're like, we heard you were going for Mount Hamilton. Stop going, don't go for the backside that the race is going. Nobody rides that way because it's really far. They wanted me to ride from San Jose, which is like the longer way up the climb, but not the way the race goes. So that's the one that like all the locals did. And I heard that enough that I kind of put it on Facebook and put it to a vote. And it was an overwhelming majority to go up from the Mount Hamilton side. So that's the good news because it meant that I didn't have to drive an hour and change just to get to the start of the climb. So has it ever been good news that you have to ride up a mountain for an hour instead of 22 minutes? But that's the situation. So here we are. The climb now, it's a different effort. It's average 4%, which is not much. A friend told me it's a time trial bike climb, and that's not going to happen. But it's still like 4,000 feet of altitude gain. I just drove it on accident because my GPS screwed me. And there's some downhills. It doesn't look too scary, but I will not be in my drops that don't exist. Actually, I have enough drop. I might even use them just to annoy everybody. Here we are, I gotta go warm up. Any tips for the descent? You know anything about this?
Oh, a couple of tips.
On the way to town?
Do you remember, like, tell me, hang on, from your memory, give me, like, turn by turn, how to go down that thing.
Hamilton. You don't remember. Hamilton, I can go down fine.
Oh, yeah, we were in the city. This isn't too soon. You were joking about it that night, so I know it's not too soon.
It's totally fine.
And I don't go down anyway. I take a car down.
No, actually, watch for snakes.
Also watch for snakes.
Because, like, before it crashed, we saw, like, two.
That's what I heard. Do we know if it was a snake? You're never going to know if it was a snake you hit.
The TV camera guy even said it was a snake.
How come the internet hasn't talked about that yet?
I don't know. The TV camera guy doesn't have internet.
What if you just tweet that? Be like, hey, by the way, it was a snake.
I don't want people to know I got taken by a small snake.
Tom's is okay. It's gonna be okay. The record for Mount Hamilton is currently held by Kirk Carlson. He was U23 national champion in 2008. I was fourth in that race. I'm still bitter about it. He rode for Slipstream, and then he and I were teammates briefly on Bissell. Now he's in grad school somewhere down in the valley, taking out his retirement on Strava, which I wouldn't know anything about. It's a beautiful climb. I can see why the San Joseans insisted that we go up that way. I paced it well. That was just one of my better one-hour powers somehow, after a long week especially. And I'm definitely glad I saved a good bit for the last few minutes where it got steeper. I was high up, but I managed to not explode. That last bit of the observatory stung for sure.
God, that hurt. .102.39. Kirk Carlson at .105.45.
After a long weekend, I was grumpy at the end, and I had to get directly into my car. No cool down, directly into the Velofix van, which drove me to my car, which then drove to Pismo to get out more cookies. It's a tough life, this retirement.